How many Bibles are there? And how many books are there in the Bibles? If you're asking how many different asterisk versions asterisk of the Bible there are, well, let's just say there's a plethora. Different denominations, scholars, and time periods have all produced their own translations and interpretations, leading to the multitude of Bibles you might see on a bookshelf, ranging from the King James Version to the New International Version to the Message, which reads like a novel. Now, diving into the nitty-gritty of how many Bibles is a bit like going down a theological rabbit hole. Each Christian denomination may have a slightly different answer based on the canonical books they recognize. Some may include books that others consider apocryphal or non-canonical. But if we're talking about the most commonly recognized versions of the Bible, let's break it down. The Protestant Bible commonly contains a total of 66 books, with 39 in the Old Testament and 27 in the New Testament. These books have been vetted and universally accepted by Protestant denominations through a long historical process of canonization that solidified which books were in and which were out. The Roman Catholic Bible ratchets that number up a notch. It includes several additional books known as the deuterocanonical books, bringing their Old Testament count to 46 books. Add that to the same 27 books in the New Testament, and you're looking at 73 books total. The Eastern Orthodox Church steps up the game even further. Their Bible contains even more books in their Old Testament, which can bring their total up to somewhere around 78 books, though this number can vary slightly depending on specific Orthodox traditions. Now, these are the big three that you'll encounter most frequently, especially here in the States. But keep in mind there are other Christian canons out there, like the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Church, which recognizes a whopping 81 books as canonical. Isn't this a fascinating buffet of biblical proportions? Yet, while the numbers vary, the core of the scriptures tends to remain consistent across the board, focusing on the teachings and storylines central to Christian doctrine. Living in Portland, I've come across an eclectic mix of these different Bibles, reflective of the city's diverse religious landscape. It's pretty cool to see how many unique versions exist, each with its own history and context. If this topic intrigues you, I suggest popping into one of Portland's quaint bookshops. I can lose myself for hours browsing those shelves. Just remember, whichever Bible you pick up, the number of books contained within opens a window to the traditions and beliefs of the people who hold that version dear.